The term political offense has been vague, and there is no internationally agreed definition of this term. It is argued that the most heinous, in other words, serious crimes such as genocide, war crimes, crime against humanity are not considered as political crime. Even for terrorism, we see if the terrorist activity is done, it cannot be considered as a political crime. Even we see one of the case regarding this. So, in are not political crimes, and in order to refuse extradition. So, international law has, however, made various efforts to limit the meaning and scope of this term. Some of these initiatives are listed below. First initiative is attendant clause. So, this clause was originated in the year 1856 in Belgium and was followed by other states. This clause provides that a murder of the head of foreign state or of a member of his family should not be considered as a political crime. In other words, while establishing the government during those rivalry, if the head of the state was killed by another person belonging to another political party, or member of his family can be killed or murdered, then it should not be considered as a political crime, and state should not refuse extradition of such an accused on the ground that he committed a political crime, and such heinous crime must be excluded from the definition of the political crime. So this clause is called as attendant clause. Attendant is a name of person who suggested this clause. So this is the first effort made in the year 1856. So today this attendant clause was followed. If the head of state was killed, it is not a political crime, and person or accused of such murder can be extradited. Second effort is genocide convention. We referred this already, 1948, under Article 7 of this convention. The crime of genocide is not to be considered as a political crime, as it is excluded from the category of political offenses for the purpose of extradition. Genocide, using of weapon of mass destruction, mass killing. Third effort is the European Convention for the Suppression of Terrorism. So, it excludes terrorist acts from the ambit of political crime that we've seen already. The next effort is the Statute of International Criminal Courts in 1998. We are not talking about International Court of Justice. That is different. That court is established to settle dispute between two states. Here, one another statute called as Rome Statute, by which International Criminal Court is established in the year 1998 in the Rome itself. Through that court, the head of the state were tried for committing certain offenses. So, as per that statute of 1988, it puts a general obligation on the state parties to the convention to cooperate fully with the court in its investigation and prosecution of crime within the jurisdiction of the state. So, crime within the jurisdiction of the court are the crime of genocide, crime against humanity, war crime, and crime of aggression. So, four kind of crimes which were covered by the International Criminal Court, that is genocide, crime against humanity, war crime, and crime of aggression. For these crime, it should not be considered as political crime, and extradition cannot be refused on this crime. Genocide we referred already. Genocide convention was also there, that is the crime of mass killing. Second is crime against humanity, violation of gross violation of human right. War crime, non-observance of rules relating to war. During the war, that is war crime, and crime of aggression is an encroachment made. It was yet to be defined what crime of aggressions are. So for that crime also, no political offense, and they can be extradited. In other words, for this crime, accused can be extradited. So, with these efforts, we can say the concept of political crime is nullified up to major extent. Thodkyat, पॉलिटिकल क्राईम या व्याख्येची व्याप्ती बऱ्याच प्रमाणात कमी करण्यात आलेली आहे आणि आता पॉलिटिकल क्राईमचा प्रश्न उद्भवत नाही. प्रत्येक राष्ट्रामध्ये राज्यघटना आहे, डेमोक्रेसी आहे, त्याच्यानुसार तिकडे सत्तांतर होतं. क्वचित काही राष्ट्रांमध्ये रायव्हलरी होऊन सत्तांतर होऊ शकतं, त्याचवेळी पॉलिटिकल क्राईमचा प्रश्न येऊ शकतो. आणि मग एखादा आरोपी दुसऱ्या राष्ट्रात पळून गेला असेल त्यावेळी तिकडे तो जाऊन सांगू शकतो की तिकडे मी पॉलिटिकल क्राईम केलेलं आहे त्याच्यामुळे मला तिकडे एक्स्ट्राडिट करू नका. मग प्रश्न निर्माण होईल ते पॉलिटिकल क्राईम आहे का नाही. तर त्याच्या व्याख्येवर ती व्याख्या वेग असल्यामुळे ती व्याख्याच काढून टाका असं काहींचं लोक म्हणणं आहे. मग ते पॉलिटिकल क्राईम असो नसो एक्स्ट्राडिशन करा, पण आज तरी या रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स लक्षात घेऊन पॉलिटिकल क्राईमची व्याख्या ठरवली जाईल आणि मग ठरवलं जाईल त्याला एक्स्ट्राडिट करायचं आहे की नाही करायचं. सो विथ दिस वी हियर आर कन्क्लुडिंग द टॉपिक ऑफ एक्स्ट्राडिशन. सो व्हाईल कन्क्लुडिंग वी कॅन से दॅट द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ एक्स्ट्राडिशन इज वन ऑफ द प्रिन्सिपल कन्सेप्ट दॅट वॉज डेव्हलप्ड बाय इंटरनॅशनल ज्युरिस्ट फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ प्रॉपर ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ क्रिमिनल जस्टिस. क्रिमिनल जस्टिस सिस्टम प्रस्थापित करणे आणि त्याचे उद्देश साध्य करणे याच्यासाठी एक्स्ट्राडिशन प्रोसेस आहे. सो पर्सन हू कमिट्स अन ऑफेन्स ऑन द टेरिटरी ऑफ वन स्टेट अँड एस्केप्स टू अनदर स्टेट द स्टेट ऑन हूज टेरिटरी द ऑफेन्स वॉज कमिटेड इज अनेबल टू पब्लिश इट बिकॉज ही वॉज नॉट फिजिकली अवेलेबल. देअरफोर द स्टेट ऑन हूज टेरिटरी द ऑफेंडर रिसाइड्स थ्रू द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ एक्स्ट्राडिशन शुड सरेंडर हिम टू द अदर स्टेट. इफ ड्यू टू रिस्ट्रिक्शन इम्पोज बाय इंटरनॅशनल लॉ द स्टेट इज नॉट इन अ पोझिशन टू एक्स्ट्राडिट देन इट हॅज टू पनिश हिम अंडर इट्स ओवर लॉस बिकॉज इट इज इक्वली इन ऑफेन्स इन सर्टन कंट्रीज देन दे मे पनिश हिम इफ इट इज अ क्राईम ॲज पर देअर ओन लॉ बिकॉज ही मे टेक देअर डिफेन्स दॅट ही हॅड नॉट कमिटेड एनी क्राईम अगेन्स्ट धिस पर्टिक्युलर स्टेट नायदर अगेन्स्ट द सिटीजन ऑफ धिस कंट्री देअरफोर ही कॅनॉट पनिश्ड. सो विथ दोज रिस्ट्रिक्शन्स दिस कॅन बी डन. सो देअरफोर नो ऑफेंडर शॅल गो अनपनिश्ड इन दी वर्ल्ड. विथ दिस कन्सेप्ट द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्स्ट्राडिशन इज मेड. सो विथ दिस वी कम्प्लीटेड द कन्सेप्ट ऑफ extradition as per international law as well as national law. Yes, now if you have any queries you may ask.